Reverend Yakubu Pam, who is also the chairman of Christian Association of Nigeria, 19 Northern States and the FCT, said he was in Southern Kaduna specifically to commiserate with people of the area over the recent avoidable killings that took place there. He said that his first place of call was the palace of the paramount ruler, the Agwateb of Tiaf Chiefdom, Dominic Yahaya, to condole and sympathize with him over the unfortunate happening there. Reverend Pam reminded the chief custodian of the Tiaf Chiefdom too that he had earlier visited the governor of Kaduna State, Malam Nasir El-Rufai, to commiserate with him. He called on the traditional ruler to continue with his peaceful disposition for harmonious coexistence.
It is not time to apportion blame to each other. Especially locally here, I call on the Southern Kaduna people. Let's stop blaming each other and look for the way forward. Mm-hmm. I have said it to the governor, and I'll repeat it here, that we need to seek discussion, dialogue with all the people of Southern Kaduna to sit down and proffer solution.
Responding, the royal father was full of shock, wonder why the once peaceful chiefdom has become a river of blood.
And I met some Fulani leaders, those that talk and they'll be listened to, and Fulani leaders elsewhere in the country. So we are pulling them for a summit here so that we can discuss ways and means of, one, relieving the tension in the land, stopping these attacks, and the Fulani that have migrated out to come back, and any other person that has left because of the insecurity to come back to the land.
Reverend Pam was also at the palace of Agwambaju Nubaturi, who expressed regrets at the unfortunate happening.
And this incident occurred. This element of brotherhood has been so pronounced that so many people from various other groups within the Southern Kaduna have offered assistance in one way or the other. Your visit is by no means a minor activity for you to have come all the way from Abuja.
The Executive Secretary's delegation was at Zonkwa, where Reverend Yakubu Pam addressed internally displaced persons and called on them to forgive, forget, and keep praying to God to avoid the occurrence.
I want you to know that you are not alone here. We are together with you, and Jesus is with you. So you should always feel free to pray. Don't forget God. And life in camp used to be funny. If you are not disciplined, they will turn you to be something else. So please be disciplined. Continue to pray. In all that you do, put God first.
Earlier, coordinator of the camp, Reverend Gambo Waziri, gave a vivid account of how the place came into being.
Women are helpless, running some without clothes and shoes. So helpless, so we just took the step following the teachings of Jesus Christ.
The executive secretary of NCPC, along with his team, also visited Laduga to console the internally displaced persons there.
Abun da ya faru aikin shedan ne. A lokacin da ana cikin bacin zuciya, zuciya ba kashi. Zaka yi aka aikata abun da gobe sai ka ce da na sani.
Responding, leader of the community, Adamu Musa, expressed surprise and appreciation for the visit.
Muna godiya kuma muna nuna farin cikin mu da yadda kuka baro ayyukan ku musamman domin ku ziyarci al'umman mutanen Laduga da suka yi hijira daga wurare suka shigo. Mun gode.
Contributing, Federal Commissioner representing Northwest in the commission, Reverend Binyard, said they are putting all hands on deck to ensure peace is achieved. Some of the IDPs from both sides of the divide lamented the hardship confronting them. It has become imperative that war benefits no one. Hence, peace reigns the panacea. This is Roland Lungs.